Excuse me, Mr. Seymour. You seem a nice man, but you're a terrible liar.
Excuse me back, detective lady. I'm a terrific liar.
We're supposed to keep tabs on a possible major strong-arm guy, and you want us to do it in open cars?
Excuse me, ladies, would you mind getting out of your car?
It's gonna be a monster. I can feel it in my kishkis.
In your what?
Down my own factory.
How's business, Mr. Seymour?
Don't ask.
Cream, two sugars.
Thank you. You got such a punim. You know what a punim is?
Yes, sir, thank you. I am asking, Mr. Seymour, how's business?
For 25 years, stocks go up, hemlines go up. Stocks down, hemlines down. It was easy. Well, not so easy. Now there's minis and maxis above the knee, below the knee. Who can guess this Michigan of business?
So this nice, convenient fire solved a lot of your problems.
Nice. The insurance company, those gunniffs, don't pay off without the say-so I didn't do it. And now you two ladies are giving me the third degree. Nice. Very nice.
What my partner is saying, sir, is that eventually you will get the money.
And you think money's gonna do it? Money makes up for 43 years of sweat and blood?
Mr. Seymour, the fire department says it was definitely arson.
Why should I do such a thing? I had a wonderful line coming out.
Well, if you didn't do it, who did?
I don't know.
Excuse me, Mr. Seymour. You seem a nice man, but you're a terrible liar.
Excuse me back, detective lady. I'm a terrific liar. I've been in the schmutter business for 43 years.
Okay, Mr. Seymour. You are not lying. You don't know who it is. But you have a pretty good suspicion. Am I right? Who are you protecting, Mr. Seymour?
You know I got great grandchildren. Two already. And eight grandchildren. All from three daughters and a wife. Who am I protecting? A business you can rebuild. Family. I tell you the name, that's the end of the story. I don't sign nothing. I don't go testify. Otherwise, I came into this world with nothing. I can go out the same way.
Claims that some company called Ashland Trucking has been trying to take over the delivery business of the whole garment district. No one's saying anything outright, but three fires later, they're getting the idea.
It looks like there could be something to it, sir. Nelson Ashland's been in the business a little over a year now. He already gobbled up a good chunk of the trade, and nobody wants to say how.
Organized crime?
Well, we ran the name past OCCB, but they've never heard of him.
So all you got is a situation that smells inky and a story from this Seymour character. He doesn't want to cooperate?
He gave us the name, that's all he's got. Plus, he's an old man. He wants to retire and spend some more time with his great-grandchildren.
Well, what do you want from me?
24-hour surveillance on Nelson Ashland.
Well, come on, Cagney. That's three sets of detectives, six men off the duty roster on the word of a man who may be covering up his own handiwork.
I believe him.
So do I, sir.
All right. So I'll think about it. In the meantime, if I recall, you two are still bringing up the rear in this squad when it comes to paperwork. I figure you got 45 minutes till shift change. How about it?
Yes, sir.
Good.
Well.
Oh, yeah. I'll talk to Nelman about the surveillance.
Thank you, Lieutenant.
Your sergeant's exam. Coleman, you'll make book on anything, won't you?
Come on, LaGuardia, it's a natural. You have Petrie going out at 3-2. He's the odds-on favorite.
What about Cagney and Lacey?
Got them both at 4-1. No way two women from the same squad are gonna make sergeant. The way I figure, one sort of offsets the other, you know?
What about me?
7-1.
7-1? What, are you kidding?
Takes more than a pretty face, is Becky.
Obviously, if you made it.
Sticks and stones, is Becky. Sticks and stones. Okay, wanna put your money where your mouth is?
Well, not at those odds. It's ridiculous. It's insulting. Yeah, I've got as good a chance as Cagney and Lacey.
Let me get this straight. Are you saying that if I give you 4-1, you'll bet?
Careful, Victor.
It's okay, LaGuardia. 4-1.
As opposed to 7-1, right? Hey, Miss Becky, you drive a hard bargain. But I guess you're right. You know what's fair is fair. What do you want, 10 bucks worth?
Make it 50.
That's why he's 7-1.
Hi, Christine. Where's Mary Beth?
Harvey, what are you doing here?
I can't talk to you now. Where's Mary Beth?
She's over in the records file.
Thank you. Hey, you.
What's Harvey doing here?
I don't know, but he's wearing a suit. He only wears suits to funerals. Probably wasn't a close friend.
Ernie.
Yeah?
He's been joking with me, why, 6 years about me getting out of manual labor into real money.
Yeah.
Only he doesn't mean it because he doesn't think I can do anything else. Only now I put together this contracting thing. I prove myself. So we've been talking. Today, he puts it on the line. I start Monday.
Oh, Harv, that's wonderful. Wonderful. Harv, what do you know about tax shelters?
I'm a businessman, Mary Beth. It's business. I mean, Ernie isn't exactly Albert Einstein, you know. I mean, if he can do it and make that kind of money, why not me?
Why not?
Hey, Chris. How are you?
Hi, Mr. Lacey.
How's your pop?
Fine.
How's it look? Good.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Harv, you notice how much this wine is on the menu?
A night to be extravagant. In fact, Mary Beth, I'll tell you what.
What?
Make a wish.
A wish? What kind of a wish?
Something you always wanted, but we couldn't afford.
Harv, I don't need anything.
I want to buy you a present.
Oh, honey.
I mean it. Tell me something I can buy you. A present, a big one. Come on. You got something. Tell me.
A new refrigerator.
Oh, Bobby, we need a new refrigerator.
I don't want something that we need. I want something you want.
Okay. How about... No, it's too much.
What is it? Tell me, what is it too much?
Engagement ring. I never really cared, Harv, you know, because the wedding ring was plenty, but something I always wanted, the engagement ring, a small one.
To the lady who is still my fiancée.
Size of the office that he's gonna get. Well, the office is not so big, but the desk he's got the size of a squad car.
Oh, it sounds so terrific. So you guys gonna celebrate this weekend?
I don't know. Muriel's taking the kids for Saturday, so we'll probably do the usual, you know.
Mary Beth.
What?
Been a long time since the old folks had a Saturday alone together.
No, not that, Christine. Might do that too. Mom, probably we'll just go for a drive.
That's okay. So where are you going? Where to?
Nowhere. It's just a drive. Your Hawk likes to drive, and sometimes we stop and look at houses.
But you're not going anywhere.
Well, you never just get in the car and drive?
No, I think that's very boring. It's like window shopping.
Oh, come on, Christine. I've seen you window shop.
Only when I'm trying to kill time. Otherwise, I figure out what it is I want, and then I set out to find it.
Well, we stop and look at houses, and then we imagine if we lived there, you know.
I think that'd be very frustrating.
You never look at a dress and then imagine what it'd be like on?
Sure I do. If I like it, I buy it.
That's the difference between you and me, Christine.
What, patience?
Money.
Oh, that's very good, Mary Beth. Almost a joke. We gotta run. We have two more witnesses, and Samuels wants us back by 3.
Not a joke.
24-hour surveillance starting Monday morning. Cagney and Lacey caught the case, so they're in charge. You report to them, and they'll report to me every day, because I want to know everything that this Nelson Ashland does and everyone that he sees.
Wiretap?
No, we haven't got enough for a court order.
What kind of vehicles do we get?
Regular, unmarked squad cars.
Lieutenant, we're supposed to keep tabs on a possible major strong-arm guy, and you want us to do it in open cars?
You just used the word yourself, Cagney. Possible. This is the best that I can get out of Nelman with a possible. You give me a probable or even a very likely, and then I'll get you the whole shooting match. Until then, you got squad cars. That's it. Questions?
How long, sir?
If you don't turn anything up in a week, I'm going to have to take a long and hard look.
Who's got what shift?
Cagney and Lacey make the assignments.
We'll take graveyard.
Fighting with the wife again, Marty.
Could you do this somewhere else? Some of us still got work to do here.
Yes, sir.
And, as you know, we are back in the dining room again.
Can you see it, Harv? Having a real dining room. There's candelabras on the table. I'm ladling soup from a tureen.
Be nice.
Nice.
The place is well built.
Well, thank you. It's a lovely home, Mrs. Harkins.
No, I've always wanted my own workshop.
It just came on the market this week. Believe me, it's not going to stay around long.
I'm sure it won't. Thank you.
What are the terms?
Oh, well, it's all right here on the offer sheet. The first mortgage is assumable, and with, say, 20% down, the second is very reasonable.
What's the monthly payment?
Well, depending on the down and the interest rate on the second, it would be somewhere between this figure and this one.
Thank you very much.
Hold on a minute, Mary Beth. Could I talk to my wife?
Oh, of course.
Oh, I know what you're gonna say.
You like the house?
No. I don't like the house. It's a wonderful house, of course.
I like it, too, a lot.
Harv, we can't afford this house.
I know it's a stretch, Mary Beth, but with the new job, the tax break we get, I think we could almost do it.
Do you mean it?
Yes.
Are you serious?
You want me to buy your house?
This house here?
Yes.
This house right here?
Yes.
Thank you.
I don't want to move.
Quit, Belly. I can finish your breakfast.
If I change schools, I'm not going to be eligible for basketball.
Nobody said we're moving yet.
All my friends are here.
He means Julie Knight.
Keep it up, Ronan. I'm going to kill you.
Hey, what kind of talk is that? Bob Jr., I need to pick up a pound and a half of ground beef for dinner after school.
You've got practice. How come Michael never has to?
Because I'm not old enough.
Whoever goes can pick out dessert, all right?
Hi, guys.
Hi, baby. Oh, honey. Oh, look at you. You look... I didn't know the word for it.
You like it?
Yeah.
Pretty good for off the rack, huh?
Yeah.
I think you look funny.
You do, huh? Well, get used to it, kiddo. Your father's in a big time.
Oh, handsomer.
Handsomer?
That's the word. Yeah. Handsomer. You were always handsome, but now you're handsomer.
I gotta go.
Yeah. I'll be thinking about
okay.
you. Honey, you forgot to...
Holy... What is that?
Nothing. Never mind. I made lunch for you.
Expense account, Mary
Beth. Expense account.
See you.
Do good.
See you guys tonight.
Okay, which one is going? Decide what's fair.
I'll go.
Yeah? All of a sudden you're old enough, huh?
Do you think Ashton's ever gonna go to work? I don't know, Chris. But I got a couple extra BLT on whole wheat. If you're interested for later.
Oh, thanks. You know, Mary Beth, your house sounds really wonderful.
Oh, it is. It's got this little room in the back that Harvey's gonna put in a skylight for me. I could grow flowers all year long. I mean, it's nothing like Ashton's place here, but it'd be nice for the four of us.
Well, what do you want with a white elephant like that? All you'd have to do is wash windows all day long. Look at the lawn. I'm telling you, if that isn't AstroTurf, Ashton spends every weekend behind a lawnmower.
You're making fun of me.
Oh.
It sounds like you're making fun of the house I want. I mean, it may not be a big deal to you, Christine.
I'm not making fun of your house. I was just giving you the downside to ownership. I mean, look, their property taxes, maintenance.
Well, that's very easy for you to say, Christine. You own your law.
Exactly. That's
you
I know.
You always own the house you lived in.
That isn't true. When I went away to college, I did not. When I lived with Charlie, I
oh,
did not.
Oh, yeah, when you were waiting for your trust fund to come in. No, I'm sorry, Christine. No offense, but you don't know what you're talking about.
Well, on the contrary, Mary Beth, I do know what I'm talking about. That's why I'm trying to advise you.
Now, let
there
me tell
are two sides
something.
To
There's
ownership.
There's one thing about this country. When you're growing up, they make promises to you. I mean, nobody says them, but when you're a little girl, they promise that you're going to grow up, and you're going to find a terrific man, and you're going to have terrific children, you're going to settle down in a nice, terrific house somewheres, a house you own. I know nobody says it, Christine, but I've been feeling cheated all my life because I couldn't afford a house.
Well, that's stupid, Mary Beth. I've never had a husband. I've never had children. I do not feel cheated. My life is fine.
By choice, Christine, which is the important thing. I mean, a house, the owning of something like that. People like Harvey and me, there's almost not a choice anymore. Only now we got one. I don't know.
It's the American dream, right? It's important to me. Well, I'm happy for you, Mary Beth. I really am. And I'm sure you have a nice house.
If we get it. I mean, we still have to work the price down. We have to get a second... Christine?
Excuse me, ladies. Would you mind getting out of your car?
Officer, we're Detectives Cagney and Lacey, 14th Squad, New York City. I will reach into my pocketbook to get my ID. My partner will get out of the car, and I will place my ID on the seat for your inspection.
Right-hand pocket. We're staking out someone in that house over there.
Mr. Ashland?
You know him?
He's the one who called. He thought maybe you were casing the place, planning a burglary.
Good morning, Mr. Ashland.
Thank you, officers.
Oh, Lord.
Cross.
It was embarrassing, Lieutenant. Two Nassau uniforms laughing at us like we're a couple of Keystone cops. Now, we gotta have vans or something.
Cagney, I told you already, I cannot go to Nelman for more on the basis of an unsubstantiated hunch. Now, give me some ammunition. You still got a couple of days.
Come on upstairs, I want to talk to you.
Want to try Mr. Seymour? Maybe change his mind. Sure. You're the one with the nice punim.
I call it the Mr. Woman's haberdashery look. I woke up one morning and saw the whole line in my head. Pretty nifty, huh?
Mr. Seymour, you told us you were retiring.
What can I tell you? Harvey Horsher calls, says he's shucking the whole thing, going to Miami Beach. He'll give me a deal on this place if I come in lickety-split. So, Frieda's Frocks is back in business.
So your wife said. Mr. Seymour, you haven't even collected on your insurance yet.
Don't worry. Don't worry, I will. I have a little something in the bank, so I'm back in the game. I already got orders from two of the biggest chains in the country.
You can do it that fast.
That's the beauty of the schmata business. A few thousand dollars, a couple of designs, and a good name, you're in business. The fabrics go to the cutting service. The cut fabrics go to my sewing contractor. His people send me the finished dresses, and the shipping contractor picks them up. All done on a handshake. A wonderful country, America.
That easy, huh?
And next month, I may be taking out a second and third mortgage on my house.
You do that?
When you want something, you do what you gotta do. Otherwise, nobody's gonna give it to you.
Mr. Seymour, tell me something. This time, are you gonna use Ashland Trucking Company?
Who knows? I'll look them all over. That's a nice coat.
Thank you.
You mind if I ask you how much you paid for it?
Mr. Seymour, we need your help. If you'd sign this statement,
you,
we could get
authorization. You, if you'll excuse me, need something a little more stylish. Camel's hair, maybe.
Mr. Seymour, the way my partner and I see it, you've got two choices. Either you give in and you hire the, what do you call it? It's the gunifs, thieves, right? Which is hard to picture for you. The son of a man whose wife tells us works as a cutter every day of his life, even after his son could well afford to support him in retirement. Or else you go up against Nelson Ashland again. In which case, you'll be asking for another fire, or worse. So, Mr. Seymour, oh, you ask him. Please, sir. He's a remarkable man. 71 years old.
71?
Yeah, and he's excited like a kid over starting up again. Anyway, now we got him as a registered confidential informant, and the lieutenant's gonna try and get us everything. Two surveillance teams, 12 detectives, vans, and a whole bunch of wiretaps, and Christine is all hacked off because it's part of the deal I made with Mr. Seymour. I promised that we would be the ones to personally watch his place, which means that Petrie gets to lead up the team that's tailing Nelson Ashland. Anyway, she's so competitive, you know. Are you listening to me?
Sure. That is terrific, babe.
How come you're sitting there smirking like you know something?
Me? I don't know nothing. Oh, by the way, do you know that you had dinner with a very rich man tonight?
Huh?
Yep. I closed my first deal today.
Oh.
I don't know how the guarantee comes off the commission, but either way, it is a nice piece of change.
He told me it was gonna take a while.
Ernie says he doesn't believe it. I'm telling you, Mary Beth, this stuff is easy. I mean, I learned a couple of catchwords and bang, these people sit around and listen to me like I'm doing magic tricks.
Rich person, huh?
That's me.
Did I ever tell you I have this thing for wheeler dealers?
I didn't tell you the best part. There is this guy named Foster. He is about to confirm tomorrow an even bigger deal.
You know what I think?
What do you think?
I think that this calls for a proper celebration. You want to join me in the bedroom?
Oh, gee, I wish I could, Mary, but I got to finish my paperwork.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Is it going to take long?
Well, when I'm done, I'm done. Why don't you go in now, and I'll join you later. Okay?
I might be asleep.
Well, I'll be quiet so I won't wake you.
Harv, if you want to wake me, wake me. It's okay.
Good night.
Get him?
Yeah.
We had wiretaps. We'd know who we were taking pictures of. This is so stupid, getting shots of everyone who goes to Seymour's building.
One more piece of evidence. That's what the lieutenant said. And Nelma's gonna have to give us the right equipment. Want a coffee?
No, it might keep me awake.
Harv closed his first deal yesterday. Got another suit, three pieces with a vest.
What? No, it's nice. I don't know, it's just hard to picture Harvey in a three-piece suit. Why?
I don't know.
It doesn't fit. You know, I mean, some of it fits, but... Oh, Harv. I just can't see him in a three-piece suit. You know what I think? I think you got a prejudice against men with blue collar, Chrissy.
Oh, come on, Meredith. That is ridiculous.
Yeah? Have you ever dated one? In the last 10 years, have you ever gone out with a man who did not graduate from college?
I don't remember.
I rest my case.
That does not mean I'm prejudiced.
I'm not making a value judgment here, Christine. I'm simply pointing out an observation, that's all.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So did you make another offer on the house?
Okay, put it over there.
Mary Beth? Did they accept?
I'm very superstitious about things like this, Christine. Okay, we got 60 days, and I'm going crazy every night looking at mortgage rates.
Oh, that's terrific.
No, it didn't happen yet, and it could fall through, and I don't want to talk about it anymore, okay?
Okay.
I haven't been so excited about anything since Michael was born. What are you doing?
I'm taking a picture of my partner.
They're going to develop that in the police lab.
They can't take a joke to hell with them.
Stop that.
I don't see anything hinky in all of this. You?
With due respect, sir, if you knew you were under surveillance, would you do anything incriminating, sir?
On the other hand, there's not been one torch job in the garment district through this whole time, either.
Yeah, but this can't go on indefinitely, Cagney. Crime hasn't stopped in the street just because we got a hard case. I got new business coming through that door every hour.
Well, let me show you one odd situation, Lieutenant. Now, that's Monday, 1 p.m. at the 12 Months restaurant. It's a big deal three-martini business lunch. Ashland puts it away pretty well, right through a big dessert and coffee. He left at 2:45, and then, just 20 minutes later, he goes to another restaurant. He stops at the Cup of Coffee coffee shop, 16th and 7th, reads the afternoon paper, and has another cup of coffee.
You talk to anybody?
Closest one to him was two stools away. Stayed 10 minutes, then he went back to his office.
And that's his only break from routine all week.
Anybody? Okay, LaGuardia. Finish cataloging these pictures, and Pappas, I want to see the Master DD files on my desk tomorrow morning.
Lieutenant! Lieutenant, you can't drop this investigation.
Look, a cigarette stand gets knocked over for 80 bucks, all right? That man has as much right to a detective hot on his case as anybody in the garment district does. Probably more because he's at least willing to cooperate.
Nelson Ashland is dirty, and everything Aaron Seymour said is true.
Well, you believe that. I believe that, too. But we don't have one shred of evidence here.
Excuse me, Bert. I think we have something. This photo in the coffee shop, this fellow here. I kept thinking he looked familiar. Coleman thinks so, too.
Yeah, you remember that commission on organized crime a few years ago? Took the fifth the whole day long. He's got a record as long as your arm.
Including arson. Just can't think of his name. Fenton or...
It's Faraday or something.
No, it isn't. It's Fennedy.
Fennedy.
That's it. Fennedy. 10 to 1, Ashland left the paper, and Fennedy picked it up. That I got it.
All right.
Good, fine.
Deputy Inspector Nelman, please. 10 to 1, Lieutenant Samuels.
Anybody? Small guy in a checkered sport coat. I think he's going to the tailor on the first floor. So how's it going?
I can't study with this music blasting in my ear, George. Hey, George, we have to have this music blasting.
If I cut out the monitor, you won't be able to hear anything else that's going on up there.
I love it. 71 years old and he's into country western music.
Hey, Victor, where are you going?
Lunch.
It's almost 5.
Well, I don't plan to eat.
Wait.
Hey, Bonbrun's got a free hour.
We take over stakeout on Fennedy at 6:30.
Hey, what do you think I am, an amateur? I'll be there in plenty of time.
Music getting to you?
No, it's this.
Proceedings upon felony complaint, from arraignment thereon, through deposition thereof. I mean, who understands this stuff? Well, you probably understand it. You think Coleman understands that stuff?
The test was probably easier when Coleman made sergeant.
Sure.
Yes? Can I help you?
I'm looking for Aaron Seymour.
I'm Seymour. What can I do for you?
Mr. Seymour, I represent Ashland Trucking.
Here we
go. I'd
like
to talk to you about your shipping needs for your new line that you're coming out with.
All I'm trying to get at, Mr. Seymour, is, are you going to give in or not?
Now, let me ask you smart ladies something. You ever notice how shoddy the tailoring is on most women's suits?
Beg pardon?
Now, take men's suits. Little hand stitching here, little extra tailoring there. That's quality. Now, say you want to buy a nice, classic, never-go-out-of-style woman's suit with the same oomph. You'd love it. You'd wear it forever. You'd be happy to pay $150. Verstehst?
Oh, could you answer my partner's question?
Mr. Woman's haberdashery look. It's gonna be a monster. I can feel it in my kishkes.
In your what?
Kishkes. Guts. Tell you what I'm gonna do. You two ladies have been so terrific. What say I give you each a sample for all your trouble?
We can't do that.
Why not? You think it's a bribe? It's not a bribe. I like you.
And we like you, Mr. Seymour. And we thank you. But we just want to do our job.
I want you should be happy. I want everybody should be happy.
Even Nelson Ashland?
My old mother, may she rest in peace, used to tell the story. Way back in the old country, the Cossacks would come through the town with a big geschrei, hurting people. My Uncle Avram one day thinks maybe he should do a little business with them. Even Cossacks understand business. So he gives each one a chicken.
Are you telling us that you're going to pay protection to the king of the Cossacks?
What can it cost me, a chicken? 10-15% extra on the shipping? This line is going to be a monster. So I take a little less profit margin. And I avoid a lot of sewers.
Mr. Seymour...
I want to think about it. I gotta think. But I ask you, ladies, what would be so terrible?
You believe that? We're sitting out like idiots and he's caving in.
Not in a million years.
Mary Beth, you heard what he said. Did you see the look on Mrs. Seymour's face?
What is that a real thing?
That man's not gonna get a minute's peace tonight.
Hey! Am I in your way?
Where's George picking us up?
36th Street.
Creep has taken our space.
Where's Pappas?
Hello, Marcus. He's in the back.
How's it going?
Boring. Fennedy hasn't stirred from his room.
Specky.
With Bon Bon. Sorry, Marty. You'll have to stay till he gets here.
Little postprandial hanky-panky?
I don't know. But I'm sure he'll tell me all about it. In living color. Anybody go in I should know about?
Mr. Fennedy isn't exactly a social butterfly. Like I said, boring.
I guess we should be grateful.
Telling you, he did not come out that front door.
The only way out, Victor.
Good morning. Morning, ma'am. What's up?
Fennedy slipped by Petrie and his Becky last night.
You're kidding.
He didn't. And Coleman's hiking up the odds on us. Not fair.
Let it go, Victor, all right?
Okay, so you lost him. It's not the worst thing in the world.
No.
There was another fire in the garment district last night. The night watchman was critically injured.
Congratulations, ladies. You are now the favorites in the sergeant's pool. I mean, what's with the look? I didn't set the fire. I just set the odds, you know?
Six. We're covering Seymour's loft, and we're trying to reestablish surveillance on Fennedy. We lost contact yesterday. We're combing the garment district. I understand. Sir, 2 weeks ago, I was begging you for surveillance equipment. Yes, Inspector. Thank you. Isn't that typical? I got to yell and scream to get their interest in this case. Now they want to yank it back for themselves.
Sure.
Papers picked the thing up, and now all of a sudden, it's the biggest thing since Son of Sam. When's Seymour shipping out his dresses?
Any day now, sir.
Well, Nelman's given us till Friday. Then it goes to major cases.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Hey, slow down.
I've been looking at all this different bank stuff and, you know, the different rates. I mean, with a fixed rate at 13% and the variable at 11.5%, the difference is something like $130 a month. That's assuming that we put 20% down, which is what we planned. But I figured that the variable could go to what, 14.5? I'm sorry, this must be kind of boring, huh?
No. It's nice to see you so excited.
I tried to tell Harv about all this last night. Now, he works with numbers every day, but he was having trouble keeping his eyes open. Pretty boring, right?
Yep.
I wasn't talking to you. Oh, Lord. This is Seymour.
What? Seymour was worried that you should get hungry down here. I made a couple of sandwiches. Brisket, you'll like it. I took off all the fat.
Mrs. Seymour, please, this is supposed to be an undercover operation.
You young girls with your diets, huh?
Mrs. Seymour, please.
I heard about the night watchman who got burned. And so did Seymour. So, eat and be well.
Listen, you should take on a few more pounds. It wouldn't kill you.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Ready for this? She made us sandwiches.
Well, that's very sweet, but she's now compromised the stakeout.
Well, what was I supposed to do? From Aaron Seymour. I'm shipping the dresses tomorrow. If he's coming, he's coming tonight. No more chickens for the Cossacks.
All right!
What'd I tell you?
Kishkas, Mary Beth. The man has kishkas.
Nothing, Bert. He hasn't moved.
Doesn't make sense. If Ashland doesn't send him tonight, it's going to be too late.
We can see the door. We can see the fire escape. There's no other way out. He's got to still be there.
That's what his Becky said.
Falling asleep on me, are you, Chris?
No.
Fifth.
61. Son will be up there now.
Which one of these is it? Fennedy? Mr. Fennedy, are you there?
He could be in Miss Marr's apartment.
Who's Miss Marr? Fennedy!
His girlfriend on the other side of the building.
The other side of the building? Has she got a fire escape?
Of course.
Get down there, tell him to get on the radio. Fennedy may already be on his way. Open up this door. Come on, damn it, open up this door. Then we wake up the girlfriend. Come on, open it up.
Hands up in the air.
I'm on him, Chris.
Get your hands up! Stay right there. Get your hands up, I said! Fire!
Who told you move?
Stand still. Spread them. All right, you have the right to remain silent. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be...
Christine!
Sleep again, huh?
Yeah.
You have a bad day?
Huh. It's job. I don't know.
Everybody has a bad day, huh? But you can't keep on with us not sleeping.
Not doing anything, Mary Beth. I'm sitting around having lunch with these rich guys and I don't know. My stomach, I can't eat. I can't, I'm not making something. I'm, you know what I mean? I'm not accomplishing anything.
Honey, you had a bad day. You can't expect every day to make a big sale.
No, no, you don't understand. I sold two. It isn't enough.
Why?
You know, back in history when they built all those cathedrals, the workers, they'd carve their names in the stone. It was like signing their work. When I was on the high steel, I saw the Indians do that too. They'd scratch their initials on the girders. Even now when I do a remodel, I put my initials down under something where it doesn't show. Silly, I guess, I don't know. Keep thinking. I can't take Mike out like I used to and point to a building and say, I built that. My name's on it. You can't carve your initials in a tax shelter.
Then you have to quit.
It means no house.
I know.
I feel terrible.
No, come on. I've been thinking about that house, you know. I mean, what with interest rates the way they are, it may not be real smart to commit to a long-term mortgage like that. I mean, they're bound to come down eventually, huh?
I know how much this house means to you.
We'll do it. We'll just, it'll take a little longer, that's all.
I got something for you.
Beautiful harp. I can't have that now.
No, we can afford it.
Honey, we really need a new refrigerator.
No. Taking your house away, the least they can do is give you a ring.
Harv, we're going to get the house. We are, right? We're just putting it off is all. Oh, boy. It's beautiful.
You know, it's about time we got engaged. Give me a hand, will you?
I love this ring. I really love this ring. I'll tell you what. You take the stuff in the kitchen, and we'll go in the bedroom, and I will show you how much I love this ring.
Mary Beth?
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you want, maybe next summer we repaint. Now, it's about time we sprung for new carpets and drapes. Maybe we could really fix this place up. You know, all the stuff I'm doing for everybody else, you'd think I could spend a little time and energy here, right?
Right.
What do you say, kiddo? We really do a job on it.